Physics allows us to engineer our world. Sometimes the physics is intuitive to us because we all experience it so much, like how sound travels in a room. And we can engineer theaters like this one with amazing acoustics. Sometimes the physics isn't intuitive, so we have to understand it completely before we can apply it. But the applications can be incredible. For example, all of modern electronics exist because physicists figured out the quantum mechanics of a class of materials called semiconductors. There's another highly promising class of materials whose properties are also based in quantum mechanics. We call them strongly correlated materials. The most notable of these is the high-temperature superconductor, which can channel electricity without energy loss. Because of this, high-temperature superconductors could revolutionize modern electronics, leading to higher efficiency power lines, smaller and more powerful motors, and improved MRI machines for medicine. But today, even the best high-temperature superconductors currently discovered require temperatures below minus 200 degrees Fahrenheit to function. And direct study and computation, although standard approaches in physics, haven't yet provided a complete description of where these properties come from. So we haven't been able to engineer a material with these properties at room temperature. My lab is implementing a new approach, building a physical model, that is, building a separate physical system which is a direct analogy to these materials. It's just like how car safety tests will use a crash test dummy as a direct analogy to human beings to understand the impact of a car crash on humans without having to understand all the forces at play. Now, to understand our model, first we must understand what is the basic structure of materials and what makes strongly correlated materials unique. Well, every material is made up of atoms. If these atoms are arranged in a crystalline grid, then the most loosely bound electrons can break free from their parent atoms and move around the material. To these electrons, the atoms provide a landscape of hills and valleys. The electrons tend to stay in the valleys near their parent atoms, but can still move around and repel other electrons. Crucially, though, the electrons are also quantum mechanical, which for us means two main things. First, they don't move between definite locations. They're actually smeared out over many locations, and the probabilities of where you might find them are what moves between the valleys. Second, they follow additional rules. For example, no more than two electrons can sit at the same valley. In strongly correlated materials, these effects give rise to the complex behavior from which they get their name, where each electron is strongly correlated with nearby electrons. This complex behavior is what we want to understand with our physical model. The beauty of our model is that we can use other quantum particles to play the part of the electron. We use atoms, lithium atoms to be exact. These atoms are 10,000 times larger than electrons, and by placing them 10,000 times farther apart from each other than electrons in a material, we make them far easier to control and measure. But this also means that to see the same degree of quantum behavior, we actually have to lower their energies by a factor of over 100 billion. So we built a machine to achieve these astonishingly low energies. This machine uses hundreds of lenses, mirrors, fibers, and other optical elements to very precisely control lasers, which in turn very precisely control the atoms. For example, they can slow atoms down and remove energy, much like a beam of ping pong balls can slow down a rolling bowling ball. With lasers, we can also create a grid of high-intensity points of light, And in doing so, we recreate the landscape that electrons in a material see. Less light gives us a shallow landscape where it's very easy for the electrons to move around, while more light can give us a deep landscape to restrict atom movement. In fact, by changing the overall intensity of light and the number of atoms in our model, we can change the type of material we study. And then if we rapidly snap on our lasers to maximum power, we can freeze all atoms in their tracks and pin them in place. We can then take a high-resolution picture of where they all are to read out information from our model. Here's one image that I took, a raw picture straight from my experiment. Each of these blue dots is an atom, and they're all sitting perfectly within our grid. Now, patterns within these pictures tell us how our atoms behave. The presence of certain patterns have confirmed that we can make our atoms behave as electrons do in familiar materials, such as metals or insulators. The presence of another pattern was the signature that we could make our atoms behave as electrons do in one type of strongly correlated material, called the antiferromagnet. With our model, our current goal is to use these patterns to complete the profile of the high-temperature superconductor, to learn how the electrons within arrange themselves to channel electricity without losing energy as heat. And while we may be able to contribute to a new wave of technology in this way, to me, our model is more than just the path to understanding these materials. These models are one way to harness the complexity of quantum mechanics, to solve problems and learn something that existing methods cannot teach us. And I think it'll be the first of many. Thank you.